everyone. Happy Masonville Monday. Today we're doing a creature feature with one of our turtles, so keep on watching if you'd like to meet our resident Diamondback Terrapin, Squirtle. So here he is. He is extremely friendly and also very active right now because he's getting ready for his feeding time. Let me see if I can get you guys a closer look. There we go. So Squirtle here actually lives in brackish water. So for many of our students and visitors, you probably already know that brackish water is a mix between salt and fresh water. And a fun fact is that Diamondback Terrapins are thought to be one of the only turtles that live mainly in brackish water. So in their native habitat or in the wild, you would commonly find diamondbacks in the Chesapeake Bay or its tributaries, specifically salt marshes. They really like salt marshes. But you can also find terrapins as far up as Massachusetts and as far down as North Carolina. So they do have a wide range in which they can live, and that's mainly due to the fact that they can tolerate a wide range in salinity, so that's the amount of salt in the water. And terrapins, they actually have salt glands in their head that allow them to excrete or get rid of excess salt. So if they happen to go into a body of water that has too much salt in it, they can get that out of their system. All right, so I took Squirtle out of his tank just so you guys can get a closer look at him and so that we can talk about some of his features as well as ways to identify a Diamondback Terrapin. So I didn't mention this earlier, but there are actually 7 subsets or subspecies of Diamondback Terrapins, and Squirtle here is a Northern Diamondback Terrapin. And one of the ways you can tell which subspecies you're looking at is based on the area that you live in. So we live in the northeast of the US, which is where you would commonly see the northern subspecies. And then the other subspecies are usually in some of the lower states. There can be a little bit of overlap occasionally, but mainly in this area, you'll see northern Diamondback Terrapins. The first feature I want to talk about is Squirtle's shell. So the top of his shell is actually what we refer to as a carapace, and in Diamondback Terrapins, they can actually come in quite an array of different colors. So Squirtle here, his shell is kind of a dark gray color, maybe there's a little bit of green in there, but you can also find Diamondback Terrapins that have green shells, dark brown, black, even dark tan shells. So there is a wide range of colors that you can see. And the carapace is super important for the turtle because it provides him with protection. And then I wanted to make special note of these little plates on the top of the shell. So these plates are what we call scutes. And if you take a close look, you'll notice that there's kind of these little indentations in the shape of a ring or a diamond. So that's actually what the Diamondback Terrapin is named after, is its diamond-shaped scutes. And these scutes, they're actually made out of keratin. It's the same substance that your nails are made out of. And the turtles will shed their scutes as they grow and get bigger. So that's one cool feature. Another feature that can help you identify a Diamondback Terrapin is the color of their skin as well as the markings on their skin. So most Diamondback Terrapins have a skin color that's a little bit lighter than their shell, so almost like a light gray or an off-white, and they also have lots of speckles and streaks covering their skin. So if you take a closer look at Squirtle here, he's actually got a darker skin color than a lot of Diamondback Terrapins, but you should still see that his skin is covered with lots of little speckles. So that's how you can tell that he is a Diamondback Terrapin. And some Diamondback Terrapins have a special marking, not all though, but if you look at Squirtle's face, you might notice he's got a cool little marking that looks a little bit like a mustache. So I always thought that was a cool feature, but again, not all terrapins have that mustache marking, so you can't necessarily use it to identify a terrapin. The last feature I want to discuss is the bottom of Squirtle's shell, called the plastron. And if we take a look at his underside, you'll notice that the bottom is very flat And this is a typical feature of diamondback terrapins because they are mainly aquatic turtles. So having a flat bottom of the shell allows them to be more streamlined and swim easily through the water. I put Squirtle in this little tank just because he was getting a bit squirmy. But again, those are some of the characteristics you can use to identify a diamondback terrapin. And now I want to talk about some other features of terrapins, specifically the fact that they are sexually dimorphic. And what that means is that they have different characteristics based on their gender, and you can use those features to determine if your diamondback terrapin is a male or a female. So the first feature is relating to their size. Females tend to be much larger than male diamondback terrapins, almost twice the size, so they are much larger. And you can see Squirtle here is pretty small for a terrapin, so that's one way we know that he's a male. You do have to be careful because turtles that are in captivity don't tend to get as large as wild turtles because of the limitations of their tank size. So they'll only grow as large as their tank allows. Another thing that can be difficult is if you don't have two turtles to compare, so you can't compare a male and a female, then you might not be able to tell the relative size of your turtle. If looking at the size of a diamondback terrapin is a little bit too difficult to determine the gender, you can also look at their tail size and length. So male diamondback terrapins tend to have much chubbier and longer tails. So let's try and take a look at Squirtle's here. He's unfortunately got it tucked under right now. But you should be able to tell that it's kind of chubby. And then female turtles will have a much shorter and skinnier tail. So that's one really good way to identify a diamondback terrapin's gender. Alrighty, so I gave Squirtle his food. He was getting kind of impatient, wanted his oysters. That's his absolute favorite food. And diamondback terrapins like Squirtle, they really like to eat mollusks. So a mollusk is any sort of hard-shelled animal. So that includes clams, mussels, oysters, even aquatic snails. And sometimes they'll also eat crustaceans like crabs or even fish. And Squirtle, because he does live in captivity, he also gets some aquatic turtle pellets just to make sure he's getting the right amount of protein and nutrients. One adaptation that diamondback terrapins have that helps them feed on oysters is their beak-like jaw. So they have a really, really strong jaw that can easily crack open the hard shell of mollusks like oysters. And then they can use their claws on their feet, like Squirtle is here, to help rip apart the meat of the oyster and make it easier for them to chew. You might also notice that Squirtle has webbed feet. And those webbed feet are also an important adaptation because of the waters that they live in. A lot of the areas that you'll find diamondback terrapins have strong currents and waves, so they need to be able to easily swim through that water. So the webbed feet definitely come in handy. All right, that is the end of our mini creature feature. Squirtle is back in his tank swimming around. But we hope you guys learned some cool new facts today about northern diamondback terrapins and also enjoyed getting to meet Squirtle. So we hope to see you next time.